powered by NVIDIA Quadro.
Classic Car Muscle Car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Up next on Auto Resto Mod, Vinny plays with rollers, Jeff talks hookers, and we finish up the clutch pedal support tips and tricks on the 65 Mustang.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend.
And I got a hot deal.
You think? Think again.
Oh man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
Quit playing with your rod. Brake pedal's dry. Good. According to Scott, hookers were involved with this car.
How would he know?
Well, apparently, this clutch modification that was done, because this is supposed to be over here facing the other way.
What's that got to do?
Well, he figures there were probably hooker super comps on the car.
Oh.
What kind of hookers were you?
Headers.
Dude, you need to get your mind like up out of the gutter and back on the road.
I'm just saying, every time we go to SEMA.
I don't want to talk about that.
Oh, that's right. What happened to Vegas stays in Vegas.
Ixnay, yeah, that's right. Vegas, remember that from here on out. Anyway, so what he was saying is probably they repositioned it from the backside where it's supposed to be over to here, and that's why it looked odd to us the last week. When we were working on this last week, we were like, this is not like the other one, even though the bends are all the same. And we got a little worried about it, and I talked to Scott, and Scott said, no, it probably had hooker super comps on it at some point because of the clutch modification they made in the extra long rod, the happy rod, on the actuator. We need to get busy.
Easy with that.
We need to get busy, so let's get rolling on this thing because we got a lot of ground to cover in a little bitty time.
What do you mean? This should be an easy episode. Just watch last week's in reverse.
I can't do that. Okay, so what I've got here on the table is everything from National Parts Depot that we got to redo the clutch assembly. And basically, unfortunately, on this car, we needed pretty much everything to redo a clutch assembly. There are a couple of things that we've got here that are different from what the original stuff was. This is a brand new pedal support. I didn't want to use the existing pedal support because I didn't like the fact that it was bent here and it was just a little tatty looking, so I wanted to get a brand new one. This was completely missing. This is actually the stop for the clutch pedal. Now, what the guys that had the car originally did is they bent this piece here over to make a place for the pedal to bump up against. Not at all ideal. Also, this piece here was missing from the car. Now, this is the return spring for the main spring on the actual pedal support. And one thing I'm going to tell you about real quickly here is when you're doing this, you will want to get these bushings. Get these from National Parts Depot, and they are the bushings that keep this spring from impacting this and going into the metal. You've got to have those bushings. If you don't have them, you're going to just end up messing up the pedal assembly again like before. Brand new clutch arm, and I tell you what, I really like this. It's got a Zerk fitting on the bottom of it, making for a nice ability to go in and do any kind of greasing that you need to do to the assembly to keep it smooth and nice running. The one thing we will have to do on ours is this. We've gone to the later style rod assembly, so we're going to have to remove this piece here because on a 65, the rod would come through here and have two nuts on either side of it that would allow for adjustment up top. On the later 65 and 66, this was a steady piece. We also have a brand new clutch pedal. The clutch pedal in the car was so worn out we wanted to replace it, and so we did. This is a brand new piece from National Parts Depot. Looks really nice. Functionality is going to be just like factory, so we should be pretty happy with that in the car. A couple of other little detail-y items that we've got on this side of the table. These are your bushings for doing the clutch arm here, and then we also have a cover for the throwout arm, which is completely missing on the car, and also the dust boot that goes on the rod assembly that is coming out through the firewall. And finally, because ours is, again, completely gone pretty much, we got a new dust boot for the steering column itself from National Parts Depot. spring we have here on the table. This is the one that goes on the lower part of the arm here to keep this and the push rod assembly talking nicely with each other, so to speak. And then we also have all the little bushings that you need for your clutch assembly. These are required for this kind of clutch, because if you don't have these in there, you're going to end up just bashing the metal up against each other, and pretty soon it's going to be worn out just like it was before. The last piece is an original piece. Now this one I refinished here in the shop, basically took it and bead blasted it, went in and used some Eastwood Detail Gray on the upper half of it. On the lower half I used Sim Trim Black on it, and it came out looking really nice. Matter of fact, when you lay it up next to the clutch pedal assembly, it's really hard to tell that new part from the old one. Now, Vinny's going to talk to you a little bit about another option you have on the clutch pedal assembly when you're doing this, rather than replacing the entire support, going in and putting in a roller bearing system that the guys at National Parts Depot offer.
Now, if you want to reuse your brake pedal support, it is possible. National Parts Depot offers a kit, and it's called Master Roller Bearing Repair Kit. It does two things for you. Save a little bit of scratch, and you put a roller bearing in there, and it makes for a smoother clutch operation. The important piece on this is if the support itself is not chewed up and it's just the bearing, you can use this kit. You want to go ahead and cut all these tabs off, maybe using a Dremel tool, and then you have to get the old bearing out, and then you replace it with the new ones. So you've got a little spring there, the bearing. You will need a pair of snap ring pliers. Hey Jeff, come give me a hand with this.
Sure.
I can't hold that and get the snap ring.
You want me to?
Pick your poison.
I'm terrible with snap rings, but I'll try it.
All right, let's see.
So what do you need me to do?
Just, you should be able to
get it to start.
The snap ring right on the slot there.
Dummy dang! You know, that's the first time I've ever gotten a snap ring to actually work like that.
That was pretty easy.
That's nice. I know, really. That's easier than most everything else we do around here. That worked really nice.
Yeah, and we could have reused this brake support, but it's been all just beat up, and so we're just not,
I'm not real
comfortable with it.
Yeah, I'm not real comfortable with the distance we have in here now, because I know that this whole thing had been beat around and moved around with a pair of vice grips and all kinds of stuff. So I'm not crazy about what I've got going on here, so I'd rather just replace it and put the right stuff in there for what we've got going on with this car. It's going to be a driver. We probably won't be using this kit on this car, but I wanted a new pedal support and everything so we know exactly what we've got. All the stuff I've seen on this car, I'm not comfortable with this pedal support. I'm real comfortable with that. I actually like that. If we were road racing a car, that'd be going in.
So maybe we should pull these out on the new one.
No.
Okay, if you've gone ahead and you bought a new brake pedal support, you do need these studs off of the old one. And we actually have them. In order to get these off, I just like to use a couple of nuts. I'll tighten those up pretty good up against each other. There we go. That'll pull the stud right out.
All right, I'm going to start the assembly of the pedal support. Basically, you want to put it on its back. Make sure that you insert this in the proper direction. And then you'll want to go in and start the clutch pedal into the brake pedal. Now we got that inserted, and I've got another bushing that goes on this end over here. Keep all that stable. All right, now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to install the clutch pedal stop. Now you'll see that it's got a carriage bolt set up, and what we'll do is we use the fasteners from AMK that we got through National Parts Depot. I'm going to come in from the back side of this with the carriage bolt. All right, our carriage bolts tending to walk on me a little bit, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a pair of open jaw locking pliers and get on the back side of that bolt. Now we're going to clamp the bolt in place so that we can get this to turn. I get why they use the locking bolt on this, but sometimes if those shoulders are just a little bit too short, you end up fighting the box setup on here. Okay, locking pliers out. Now our support's in. Okay, now what we've done is we've installed the lower bracket for the spring, and we figured out something here. We're going to take it off the washer and the cotter pin, and we're pulling this arm out so we're just barely touching this stop. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to rock this arm back well past center. I'm going to put in my clip on both ends. I'm going to install the spring on the lower and on the upper and pull it around. I kind of like the way that sounded. All right, now I'm going to have to do something to get this to seat. So I'm going to take a leather mallet and try to pound it into position, making sure that our isolators stay in place. Okay, those are in position. Now I'm going to try and get that to seat down a little bit better. I'm going to install my washer. I'm going to take a 3/4 inch socket. I'm just going to tap that bearing or the race down. Insert the clip, ride it over. And now your brake pedal assembly is basically finished up and is ready to go into the car. And I'm going to see how this works. We've heard a couple of different ways on how to do this. I'm not so sure how we're going to get this back in the car, but boy, doesn't it look nice. Onward and forward.
All right, we're going to go ahead and remove the parking brake support, and hopefully that'll give us enough things out of the way that we can get that brake support back into the dash where it belongs.
Okay, now I'm going to talk to you about one other little detail-y item here, and that is on your Z-bar. Now the Z-bar that we have for this car is a 65-6 Z-bar, but when they build them, they set them in with this swedged piece here actually built into the bar itself, like you would have on an early 65. If you have a 66, you have to cut this out. Or if a late 65 that has the bar like we're using, the clutch bar, you have to cut this piece off. And I'm going to show you how to do that with a Dremel tool. Not really that complicated, but something you need to keep in mind of. When this thing comes in from the guys at National Parts Depot, you need to make sure that you don't get all freaked out by seeing this on here. It is part of this thing, and that's how it comes. Unless you're doing a hypo, different bar completely. But I'm going to go ahead and mount that up right now. Now another thing, you always want to use safety glasses when you're using a tool like I'm going to be using, which is our little Dremel here. Now our Dremel, I've got a cutoff wheel, which is a 426 cutoff wheel, and I'm basically going to try to go around and take the edge off of the swedge here, where you can see where they have the crosses in it. And since we've got a washer between it, I'm not really as concerned about possibly getting in and nicking up the bar here. All right, I've got that knocked down. After that cools off for a second, I can be able to knock the pinion out of there and go ahead and get it ready to go back in the car.
Okay, we had recently done a master cylinder on this car, so we were able to pull the master cylinder rod right out to get it out of our way. Now, you may not be that lucky, especially if the master cylinder has been in there for a while, so you may have to pull the brake lines off and actually move it to be able to get this rod out of your way. Another thing we did is we went ahead and rewrapped the brake pedal up just to, you know, we put some effort into painting it up and making it look pretty. We just wanted to protect it so we don't mess all that work up. Wish me luck. All right, we're trying to get that brake pedal back as far up to near the firewall as we can without taking out our fuse panel. Goes. All right, while you're doing this, just be really careful. If yours is like ours, we've done a lot of work in here, we don't want to damage. Got a little bit of wiring harness everywhere. All right, I'm going to stop here a second and make sure I don't have any wires pinched out up top. All
Okay, Jeff put a screwdriver through one of the self-tapping holes just to kind of support the bracket a little bit, and I got the other self-tapper hand tight. I'm gonna go ahead and put the other self-tapper in, and then we're ready to button everything up. And truly, at this point, the installation is the reverse removal.
All right, one last little tip I wanted to give you here before Vinny jumps in and finishes up the master cylinder and all that and getting all the other stuff installed. When you're putting the clutch Z-bar in and you've got the frame rail mount in there, what I would recommend doing is installing the Z-bar onto the frame rail mount and then putting the frame rail mount in position, loosely setting your bolts in place, taking a pry bar like the one I've got here in my hand, spinning it around so that you put some tension on the Z-bar and that felt bushing that you've got on there, because that way you'll have a pretty good idea that you're not gonna have any slip issues like we've seen on this thing from before. If that's nice and tied up against the felt, it's not going to be jumping out of there unless, of course, you lose a motor mount like this car's done in the past. You should be just fine. So now we just go in and tighten those bolts up, and the rest of it is basically what we've already shown you. So Vinny's gonna finish up the master cylinder and then we're gonna be out of here. So Vinny, you about got that in there?
Yep, last bolt, just about done. These cars sit too low.
You think this one's bad, you should see the 67 when it slammed into the ground.
Jeez.
So
maybe I get a lift.
I'm waiting for the gifter to gift it to us.
Yeah, we haven't been that good. Sam's not going to bring us one.
We've never been that good. Yeah, no, it's not going to happen. So I guess until that time, we get to do it like just like everybody else does.
I don't like it.
Well, me either, but that's the way it is. All right, folks, we're going to be coming back to you next week with how to install custom AC hoses in your car. And we've come up with a really cool tool that will actually aid you in doing that whenever you are installing those hoses, and you can do it yourself, which I like a lot. Tools not really all that expensive. If you're gonna be doing a couple of cars, actually could pay off. We're also gonna be covering some heater hose stuff that you might not know that you need to do to your classic car if you're gonna be winging that thing all the way out to high RPM. Goes around with keeping the heater core from exploding and barfing all over your carpet. So do us a favor and come back next week and watch us on AutoResto Mod.
Thanks for watching.
Get busy. You got a bunch of crap you got to do still. Come on, dude. Get back over here. Get to work.